Adding just a touch of gold to an object as a decorative element can greatly increase its value. Monetarily, yes, but aesthetically as well. The blanket term gilding includes the process of applying extremely thin sheets of gold leaf to a surface. Many items can be decorated with leaf, wood, glass, metal, canvas, paper, but perhaps the widest category where gilding has been used is in sculptural and functional pottery. With roots in the ancient world, the combination of these two earth elements, clay and gold, is still highly in demand today. The most basic technique for forming a piece of three-dimensional pottery is the pinch pot. If you're like me, you learned this as an elementary student. Roll a ball of clay, then press a finger into it to start opening the pot. Now the combination of squeezing the thumb and the fingers together in a circular motion while rotating the ball forms a very simple vessel. Now pinch pots can be a variety of sizes and shapes, as you can see in my examples. This one was formed around a pencil, so it has a very small opening. Now I've used air-dry clay for this demonstration, but kiln fire clay is formed in the same way. A pinch pot is very basic, but it can become very extraordinary with the addition of gold. Composition, or imitation leaf, doesn't actually contain gold. It's a metal alloy of copper and zinc. Now it seems like it would be very expensive, but it's surprisingly affordable and working with it can be a breeze. I'd like to show you two very easy ways to apply it to a pinch pot. Give the pinch pot time to dry, or if you're using kiln fire clay, bisque fire it. Next, brush adhesive size precisely in the area where you want the gold leaf to be applied. Now this could be all over the pot, just on the inside. I'm defining a little bit of an edge here. You could create a pattern of dots or stripes. Adhesive size is the perfect medium for applying gold leaf because it has the proper ratio of moisture and tackiness. Now I've discovered that using an adhesive that's too wet can cause metal to tarnish fairly quickly. In just a few minutes, the size loses its wet appearance and it's ready to use, like in this example right here. It will stay ready for hours, so there's no rush to apply before it gets too dry. Tear off a portion of the leaf and press it gently against the adhesive using your fingers, or you could use a soft brush. It only applies to areas where the sticky adhesive is, and you can use a brush to remove the excess. Now, even though this is black clay, it dries to a mid-gray shade. As an option, you can apply some matte black paint to give it the most contrast, or paint the entire pot before applying the sizing. A quicker process, and one that works well with younger children, is to create a crackle finish by pressing the leaf against the clay while it's wet. Something like this. Let's go back to the wet piece that I started earlier. Let's open it up just a little bit more. Then we're going to simply place the gold leaf against the wet clay. Naturally, it pulls apart to create a crackle finish. Allow that clay to dry and then put a sealer across it. Now, metal leaf is also available in imitation silver and copper, and air-dry clay offers terracotta or white colors, so you can experiment with various color combinations. All metal leaf will tarnish if it isn't protected, so brush a sealer over the clay and the leaf, and it will stay shiny. Now these cute little pots aren't meant to hold soil or water, but they're perfect for displaying air-dry plants, storing small pieces of jewelry, or catching coins, or simply providing the enjoyment they create with the gilded glow. DickBlick.com is the source for the short list of supplies you will need to make gilded pinch pots like these. While you're there, look for a downloadable PDF that lists national standards for the visual arts as it pertains to this lesson.